So today, I'm in Coram, New York to do a surprise group reading for, get this, it's a bachelorette party.
How are you?
Good,
you look surprised.
You?
And you knew I was coming.
I know. Come on in.
I'm Kathleen. I'm the maid of honor. And my sister Dawn is getting married. And I am so beyond excited.
So does she know about any
she
of this?
She knows absolutely nothing.
Nothing?
She thinks that we're like going to see a band at a bar.
A band in a bar?
It's really nerve-wracking being maid of honor. I feel a lot of pressure already. I started thinking of all different things we could do, and I know she has been wanting to get read by Theresa for quite some time now.
Oh, you're gonna go get her?
Yeah.
I guess we might as well start pre-gaming. Hi, guys.
Hi.
I'm here to pre-game. Yeah. Back in the day, you went out, you went to dinner with the girls. Now they get like matching t-shirts, they pre-game, and apparently some people want to talk to their dead relatives at a bachelorette party.
Oh, yeah.
I cannot believe this actually worked. Dawn lost it. Just absolutely, absolutely lost it.
Oh, here's your drink. I heard you were getting married. Oh my God, she's shaking. Someone better help this girl.
I freaked out. I'm a huge fan of Theresa. I've been watching her since her first season came out.
That's so weird. I wasn't expecting that.
Well, I know.
It just was not anything that I would have imagined that would have happened today.
So I'm gonna give a little quick speech on how I read, receive my information, and then we just get started. The main thing is, if you have any questions throughout the group, please do not be afraid to say anything to me. I want you to know that there truly is more to life than just here in the physical world, and that your loved ones are still with you. So, where does the mom come in that's departed? Is your mom departed? Well, how are you connected to her?
My sister.
Oh.
This is my sister.
Oh, wait, what is your name again?
Dawn.
Oh, Dawn.
Yes.
You don't look like a Dawn.
What do I look like?
I don't know, you look like a Michelle.
A Theresa.
Oh my God. That's her.
What?
That's her mother's name.
Ah! Perfect. Validating that her soul is present for this. Do you still have her clothing? Because she keeps showing me like a zip. It's just my symbol for zippered sweatshirt. You can have a sweatshirt.
Oh
there's a zippered sweatshirt.
Okay. Validating knowing of what you kept.
The fact that she brought up the zipper hoodie, that was a pretty big validation because my brother had this hoodie and my mom borrowed it from him one night and then she didn't give it back because it was really comfortable. So when she passed, I took it. And somehow or another, my brother got the sweatshirt and he took it home. And I was livid. It became a huge topic of discussion. The fact that Theresa brought it up, it's just absurd.
So she says, there's something about the dress. Because she's like, I've been with you every step of the way. And then she had me standing and then trying on dresses. And there was a moment when you put on your dress, you were like, this mom would like this.
Yeah.
Perfect.
I got my dress last weekend, and it was just my sister and my future mother-in-law that came.
Was it the complete opposite of what you thought you were going to get?
It wasn't what I thought I was going to get, no.
Perfect. Validating that your mom's soul was with you, it's the perfect dress. Your mom says, this is also about you knowing that I will be with you when you get married.
I was very, very close with my mom. The day that I got engaged, the only person I wanted to tell was my mom. I mean, I wanted to tell everybody, but I wanted to tell her, and because I couldn't tell her, it made me not want to tell anybody. I miss my mom all the time. Going wedding dress shopping and knowing that my mom couldn't be there for that, that was hard.
I don't know. Do you have a question about the way she died? Today, I'm in Coram, New York, doing a surprise reading for a bachelorette party. Because I didn't feel good, and then I feel like I literally feel like my heart just stops and I just die.
Oh my God.
how I felt.
That's what happened.
That's what happened.
She says, but I never thought in a million years that I was gonna die.
She didn't. She woke me up to drive her to school. Because she said she couldn't do it.
She didn't feel good.
Yeah.
She died on the kitchen floor. My mom passed away almost 10 years ago from heart disease. The morning that she passed away, she knocked on my door and woke me up and asked me to take my sister to school because she wasn't feeling good. And I got up, I went to the bathroom, and when I came out of the bathroom, I heard her in the kitchen. So I went in there. I saw her on the floor and I just grabbed the phone and I ran up the stairs calling 911 and woke up my dad. And that was it. She passed away in our kitchen.
She said, tell her about the shoes. Was there something that you were worried about, shoes or something?
I was worried about her getting her shoes on. I made her put the shoes on because it snowed out, but I wanted her to wait outside so that she wasn't in the kitchen watching. I'm 13 years older than Kathleen, and when my mom passed, my sister was still very young. And I always felt fortunate that I had my mom as long as I did. And I felt that my siblings were so gypped that they didn't have her for such a long time.
So she says, you also ask her all the time, would you be proud of me? So know that this is your mother's way of acknowledging that she is very proud of you. She says, but you really always did the right thing by your sister.
I tried.
She says, I don't think you realize how much it meant for me to be your mom. She says, everything else is irrelevant.
That was her favorite thing to be as a mom.
She says, and I never said this to someone before, the world is your oyster type of thing, like that kind of saying.
I say that all the time.
Shut up.
I do. I say it all the time. And I'll say it even like
when
if it doesn't.
We go get dinner. The world is our oyster.
We can have anything.
All the time.
Validate that her soul was with you at this exact moment.
My sister is my best friend. I've helped her growing up. I've watched her grow up. And now she is just a beautiful person with a huge heart. After speaking with Teresa, I know that my mom is always with me. She sees everything that's going on and makes me really happy that I made my mom proud.
Well, who's the young female for you that's departed?
My sister.
Your sister? Because she goes, if you don't say anything to my sister, she stared at that tap of the foot. She goes, you gotta let me say something. Your sister validated. The reason why she didn't say anything, because she would never, ever want to take this moment from you. So know that your sister wants to thank you for that.
I'm Mallory, and I'm hosting Dawn's bachelorette party at my house.
Your sister wants to thank you for doing all of this, for going through everything, the stress, and, you know, you're here and you're so calm. Okay, everyone, get a drink. Let's party, bitches. And meanwhile, she's like, ah, right?
Yeah.
I cannot believe my sister pulled this off. I mean, how many other maid of honors have done this for their, you know, bride-to-be? This was the most perfect, unique, and original bachelorette party that I could have ever even dreamed of.
Good luck to you, and may God bless each and every one of you. Thank you.
Thank you so much.